incredible and a very, very fast riser of the sport.
Good pressure on the receive. Lim Jong-hoon, a man of power himself in terms of the pressure in the attacking game.
But
a nice tight serve just inside the table. Lim Jong-hoon taking his chances there, getting aggressive on the receive. Nice tight serve again, tempting that opening backhand flick. Not easy to do though with that position and the forehand of Lim Jong-hoon waiting.
I'm interested here to see how Alexei gets on, because he beats people who you'd expect to beat him. He's fearless in the face of a challenge, but this is a match that he would probably expect himself to win coming in.
A little surprised we saw Lim Jong-hoon rubbing his calf there, sort of giving a self-massage for a moment, just maybe to make sure that there's no cramping going on. Interesting. He was eating a banana before the match. That's a big anti-cramp medication from nature. Beautiful backhand, as smooth as can be. Lim Jong-hoon, again, has been one of few players that's been able to beat one of the top three Chinese, arguably near his prime, Zhu Xin. A little bit off the top of the net, but again, not afraid to take big backhands from behind the table. LeBron dangerous around the court.
I love this. One thing I'll say about Lim Jong-hoon is quite an intimidating presence. He makes big compound movements.
4-5.
Still, it's funny. Just the quads. Looking at the quads, it's inspiring watching Lim Jong-hoon. He's massive.
5-0.
Kind of like Lee Sang-soo's.
Interesting. I was thinking Fan Zhendong, but yeah, there's a club of players, just a few, that are so strong in the quads as Lim Jong-hoon. Dead even here, just like the fan vote online.
That.
Ooh.
5-0.
I was going to say missed contact, but maybe he was just trying to hit it to the corner for the ball kid. I watched this grip of Alexis LeBron, the way he just so softly holds the racket for the touch play and can push long when he wants, and then as soon as he has the time, counters comfortably.
I mean, he's played less than 50 matches on the senior stage, and he's already at 22 in the world, about to go higher. For me, it just goes to show how much he's been working behind the shadows. And I mean, was it intentional to come and surprise the world? Or was the rise so fast, the improvement so quick? This is why he's now up there at the world's very best.
Well, intentional or not, the surprises are pleasant for the audience. Despite the strawberry on the point before, it's Lim Jong-hoon here who edges out in front.
By intention, by the way, I just mean the choice of when you begin to publicly compete at world events.
Oh, I think the sooner the better for most players.
That
partially a numbers game, and it's just experience. This is why ball kid adorable. I was going to say, in terms of some of the younger Chinese players, it's why Lin Shedong is such an outstanding player. Because youth implies lack of international experience. And from players like Zhou Qihao and Zhao Zihao and some others who've been quite strong over the years but just haven't really hit that next level, it's a question of international experience. So Alexis LeBron getting in early at 19 years old to be the leader for France. Pressure continues. Lim Jong-hoon taking away the big forehand by playing it right into the elbow.
Nice there. Came up the back of it. Nice and deep. Arky. Tough to time. The counter. As we saw there.
Surprise, surprise. With the height on that receive, it seemed like surely Lim Jong-hoon would attack the ball. So naturally, LeBron backs up. Lim Jong-hoon touches it short, and it gets the point.
That 6 10.
6 of the last 8 points for Lim Jong-hoon. Ripping forehand, does it, and in the rally, a dominant first game. Fire is, he can be a very fiery player, Alexis LeBron. We've seen him lose his cool, but as a fiery player, in some senses, that's just what you'd expect, right?
And there seems to be a sense of urgency with both LeBron players. They don't take a lot of time between serves, I've noticed.
They are the fastest servers in the game. Yeah, and I also wonder, for some players, it's you'll see Fan Zhendong raise his hand, Dima, whoever it is, will raise their hand to say, give me a second, I'm not settled in yet. You don't get to control my rhythm. Wow, aggressive play.
It's interesting, I saw Yuan of China, the left-hander, pick up a red card because of how many times he said to Alexia LeBrun at the Singapore Smash, please wait, I'm not ready.
Yuan Li Tun got a red card?
Yep.
Got a fascinating. Red card. There's Felix, younger brother, 16-year-old, who's also taken the world by storm. These two, the leaders for France right now by world ranking and really causing some trouble for opponents around the world. This is what it looked like when I watched him play Trules. I just felt like Alexis LeBron, while he's got the feeling, he's got the power as well. He's just so quick in his decisions. There's not a lot of backswing on almost anything.
Yeah, that's a good point. It takes everything in front of him.
Beautiful angle here, though, to put it out of reach. First towel break, both of them will take the moment. This is an optional towel break. Long serve to get right into the rally. Bit of a bottle challenge, deep to the backhand down the line. Again, the bottle challenge serve can be done by right or left-handed players. The idea is it's down the line. A little service warning there.
One.
For Alexis LeBron. A little bit shallow on the table, the last defensive shot. So LeBron and Lee Sang-soo, Jang Woo-jin, and Jin from the staff of Korea coaching, or cheering him on, I should say. So clean.
A lot of French players we've seen, like Matinee, Robineau. You know, they're the players that go back and love to defend. Gozi as well, to an extent. But Alexis and Felix seem a little bit different in that sense.
I think that's just a recipe for success, really. For Simon Gauzy to break into the top 10, one thing that he did was he stayed closer to the table and got more aggressive.
Completely agree.
But as aggressive as can be, a powerful backhand. No surprise there on where the ball was coming, and Lim Jong-hoon took advantage. Smart placement here, catching Lim Jong-hoon off guard as he was starting to move a little bit back to the backhand corner.
Good table awareness there. Played it quite from his middle there, Alexis LeBron.
How much of it do you think is knowing a pattern beforehand, and how much of it do you think is peripheral vision to do a ball like that?
I think it's more peripheral in that particular instance.
Four, eight.
Wow. Incredible court awareness. Second towel break, 4 points between them. Alexis LeBron taking back the control here, the momentum. Ooh.
4-9.
Never an easy time, but I guess if you're up 10-0, it's one easy time or better timing. Just overlifting here. What appeared to be a very flat ball. LeBron thought he needed to really lift to keep out of the net on the counter. So free and fluid with these forehands, Lim Jong-hoon.
9-6.
Going for the big finish there. Down the line. Would he have gone for that? He was 9-6 down. Not 9-6 up.
Oh, comes down from a jumping shot in the parallel forehand here. Lim Jong-hoon, the big streak now in an important moment. inside out even from the middle of the table, but playing that wide forehand line.
Wide with side.
Yeah.
Opened up the racket face. It was lovely. Got a bit of flair, even though he's known as a power player, hasn't he?
Mm. Bit of flair of his own here, and a big show to go with it. It is 3 game points for Alexis LeBron as he does a little gallop around the court.
Play bien. With Paris on the horizon, 2024. As it stands, he'd be the number one player in singles.
Seems to look that way. 3 game points now. Heavy spin and the lob comes back long. An unusual receive. He's got the creativity for sure. But what's going to earn him the points? What's the highest percentage chance of winning for Alexis LeBron? That's what he's going to want to do. You can see the nerves in the corner. Jusei Hook, legs wobbling and shaking. 2 game points left for LeBron.
That, 10, 8.
Trying out the shovel serve.
Oh. Back the pendulum. And the third ball attack just long to the short side. Still a game point left. Took the first 5 straight points in this game. And it's been pretty back and forth. Long serve carries long. He's re-gifted the service gift. If it comes down, I mean, this is the thing. At this level of play, to play a dangerous serve is worth the risk. 6 out of the last 8 points have favored Lim Jong-hoon. It's not always worth the risk, but in general, you have to take your chances. Beautiful point. The speed in this one, this is outstanding.
This is what impresses me about Alexis LeBron. Sometimes he seems too heated and too rushed in the moment, but then he can play relaxed counters like it's nothing in a really crucial moment here.
I couldn't believe the backhand he played from that far behind the table with nearly any backswing. Another game point saved by Lim Jong-hoon.
The backhand flick more towards from the forehand side. Bold play.
That bravery that is needed under pressure.
Hey.
Subtle warning from the umpire here for both players to continue. That was interesting. I mean, the grunt, just the sound of the grunt was clear that it was necessary, that it wasn't for show, but it wasn't one of the more flashy big stroke shots. Took a lot of twist and torque from the middle of the body there. Game point, Lim Jong-hoon. And he takes the game. Well now, what a comeback. Interesting service point to start too.
One love.
That was incredibly unusual. Volleyed the ball out of the air after it missed the table. No problem, hits it back on. Aggressive rip, but comes back quickly. That observation you made, tell us about it.
Yeah, Lim Jong-hoon, the youth destroyer. Everyone that he's played from round of 32 up to this point has been under the age of 20. And if he wins this, and if Lin Shedong beats Fan Zhendong, that trend would continue.
Wow. Pretty unusual in the men's game.
2-1.
In the women's game as well, but slightly younger, I feel like, the average of women players. It seems like women tend to retire a little bit younger, which is also interesting because of Ni Xialian at 59. Who's here, by the way? Nice change here. Alexis LeBron taking a lot of pace off that with the touch backhand play.
Yeah, asking the question of Lim Jong-hoon's ability to come over a slower, more shallow ball. French flair.
2-3.
And our director is bringing up some interesting players in terms of women's ages, but Han Ying, Shan Xiaona, Fu Yu, there are plenty of older women, I think, as we acknowledge 12 out of the last 16. Snake. Defense does not come down. Lim Jong-hoon, after the 12 of the last 16 points that he had won, a much-needed point here for a player who's down 0-2. Nice adjustment there, closed racket. But all those women that I've mentioned that are, say, older than the rest of the gang, it's because they left China. They left when they were young, and they found a home in a nation that maybe wasn't contending with China as the world number two, like Japan.
Yeah, three, I think 15% four. Of players at the Olympic Games, the last one, were naturalized citizens.
Fascinating. Mm. This is how strong China is at the sport.
Yeah.
So down by one here, second serve. Slow spinning with the backhand, three. And then the big finishing parallel forehand from Alexis Lebrun. Look at that. Bouncing the ball off his edge of his racket. Face edge, face edge.
Put it up. 5-4.
A nice inside-out forehand to maintain that two-point lead.
Five,
tight serve,
six.
Deception. Alexis Lebrun. Check this out. Face of the racket, edge of the racket, and he continues to do it. This is his control. Makes it look easy, just to relax. That's crazy.
20!
Come on! Remarkably well in the counter topspin game, Lim Jong-hoon. Getting that very strong flick. I mean, Alexi's grip's quite interesting to me. It's so loose. Puts the thumb especially high on the backhand.
I feel like for backhands, we see that is where the power comes from. In terms of the hand, anyway. Obviously, legs, waist. But people often ask, do you switch grips between forehand and backhand? And the answer is yes. The pointer finger on the forehand brings more power. But on the backhand, it's that thumb behind the racket driving it forward. It's been back and forth. Lim Jong-hoon has been chasing most of this game. There's a very fast sort of let's get on with it vibe from serves to receives to the ball to the corner. Everything with LeBron.
Yeah, this is the kind of harassing nature that they have. They're really in-your-face players, and they are always up to the challenge. They're fearless in the face of someone who is favourite against them, world ranking-wise.
Nine, seven.
Well, alliteration or not, 2 points between them. Alexis Lebrun with two big serves to come to continue this match. Not the first time we've seen variation in the push game save Alexis Lebrun. Again, that loose grip that you talk about and his comfort. Watch him push this ball. Just very empty. The ripping forehand does it. 11-7. Alexis Lebrun continues this match. Interesting. Left hand. Oh, just out of reach. What a spectacular defensive point from Alexis Lebrun, and it takes even better from Lim Jong-hoon on top of the bounce.
Usually you see a left-handed counter, not a left-handed lob.
And it was perfect, right near the baseline. I mean, maybe even better than the right-handed lob. It's pretty crazy. Still has his chances on the next one.
Lob two.
But yeah, Lim was playing quite a lot of backhand flicks from the forehand side in the last game, and then Alexis was going down the line to the open space. Lim's got to be wary of that here. Let's see if Alexis changes the serves.
Love three.
Remember that serve. It didn't come down on the table last time it was attempted in a game that could prove crucial.
Timeout.
The timeout now on LeBron's side. Is it secure, or is it just a question of surprise factor? So he wins the point with it either way. I think, so I've also seen it, the windshield wiper. This was a serve that was quite common back in the 80s in Eastern Europe. Something we still see from some of the top Ukrainian women. And a nice tight spin shot here. I'll be curious to see how many chances he takes in terms of mixing it up to bring a little bit of funk, something unusual against Lim Jong-hoon.
Well, this is the thing, 2-1, 3-0 down. had to be a change somewhere. And that tells me that there really was a plan here for Alexi coming into this. Probably,
three,
you know, I'm not going to use the lollipop unless I'm in trouble score-wise.
I don't remember if it was Jang Woo-jin, but either way, in Qatar not too long ago, Alexi LeBron faced one of the top Korean players and had a shocking clean sweep victory. And this is when his world ranking hadn't quite caught up to his level yet. Three in a row out of the timeout. Backhand carries just wide. Lim Jong-hoon taking advantage of staying near the table, and it's a lot of work with LeBron on the other side.
Interesting shot selection to actually open up there with the lob. Looked like he could have potentially played the counter.
Five,
the forehand, I mean.
Three.
Yeah, that is interesting. Against rules, there was very little in the way of lobbing. It was basically attack everything I can once the rally opened up. That's how it appeared anyway. Two big points there for Lim Jong-hoon to get back in front.
Five, four.
This grip that you talked about, I feel like it makes it so difficult to predict what's going to come. And he changes the spin so well, LeBron, very subtly and quickly. Back from his timeout, Lim Jong-hoon, let's see what he brings.
Four,
nothing too
six.
Crazy. Tight serve, but half long, really. Just a steady spin shot for the third ball with good placement.
I don't know what Alexi is hoping for here, but can't expect it to go any other way than him losing the way he's been receiving in the short play. Got to be careful here.
Fine balance.
That 4-7.
Tight serve of his own, difficult to read the spin. Here's Lim Jong-hoon, tries to touch it short.
Smart play, decided to change it a little bit after the let card.
So 2 points between them, still anybody's game. It's a best of five, remember, so Lim Jong-hoon can do it in this game or the next, but doesn't want to let Alexi get that close.
7-6.
Can't stop him at the moment.
Big point. I mean, he's already repeated his success of the Champions Macau last season. But he lost to a left-hander, Lim Wenroo, there. He's up against another left-hander here in Lim Jong-hoon.
Nice down the line. Lim Jong-hoon smoothly comes in. I mean, the obvious place to go would have been cross-court, so LeBron starts to move that way, just out of reach to the other side. That's where the ball goes. This is the second point between the two of them, one for each of them, where I felt like they were just smooth and patient, focused. Didn't go, I mean, it's still a pretty big shot, but it looked fairly standard for Alexi LeBron.
Nine,
big
seven.
One there, puts his hand to the core. Tight in for this backhand. Sneaks it past. 2 points away from moving on to the semifinals at a major event.
That, 9-7.
I like that LeBron does the backspin from under the net there, under the table.
Yeah.
And Lim Jong-hoon's like, nah, let's get a fresh ball without any bad history on it. Oh, burned! Holds up the racket high. Lim Jong-hoon has a strong feeling. He knows where this one's going to go. And clap above the head from Lee Song-soo. Well played. LeBron with the rocket backhand. And then the step around forehand. Just where Lim Jong-hoon is hoping for, perfectly prepared, and punches back the other way. It is 3 match points for Korea's Lim Jong-hoon. But not just yet. One saved, Alexi LeBron. We've seen the emotions of both of the LeBron brothers, and we know that the pros obviously believe that anything is possible and want to win so badly. But I think the LeBron brothers really show it at the end of a match.
Yeah. You get a strong sense of what they're trying to manifest.
And the spin shot to the short side. Lim Jong-un flexes it out and works out the match. An outstanding performance here. Korea's Lim Jong-un is through to the final four.